banter, excitement. Say hello.
Hi. One of these fell on a guy and he died.
They weigh tons.
Yeah. It's like one of those in the cartoon.
Face upstream. Face upstream.
Where?
Get that pole way upstream.
Oh, God.
The pressure's on. You see that got the camera. You can go out and help her if you want. Thank you. So how was that hill?
It was hell. On my
hill. Hell. It's all downhill to camp.
It's about as hot as hell.
Let me know when you're just gonna have fun.
Yeah, but we're not in school.
This is school.
This is school.
Cool.
I forgot. This is school. Are you learning anything today?
Oh yeah. Endurance. Self-motivation.
What you smell like.
Yeah.
Bring Eric Ping, you here? These patrols just got lost out in the desert. Tell me, Eric, what was it like out there?
It was brutal.
What was the matter there?
The trail totally disappeared.
Totally?
You got lost.
How's your brush?
Very sticky.
Uh-huh. Are you having fun, though?
No. I'm just joking. Yeah, it's fun.
Okay. I'll let you take your pack off now.
Yeah.
kid. BCTN. What are you doing up here?
I have no
idea. Oh, is it fun? Is this your first time?
What?
Is this your first time?
Right hand on the rope.
Oh, be sure to look up here and smile.
Hi.
Let me know when you start having fun.
I'm having fun, it's just scary.
You can put your other or your left hand up on the rope. Up, there you go. That sometimes makes you feel a little more secure.
Help me out with the smile again. Just get it all laid out for me so it's in a pile.
Keep those feet apart.
Keep hanging on to it with the same way like you are right there. But just either bring it to the hip or bring it to your left hand. Actually a part on this when you get to almost where she is right now. And it just drops off.
Tamara! Woo, Tamara! Hey Dan! Hang on Dan, don't move! Stay there! Stop! I'm doing an interview for BCTN! Can you tell me what you're doing up there?
I'll just hang around.
Oh yeah? Having fun yet? Okay, hang on, stop.
Here we are at a copper mine. Way up in the Mazatzal. So what do you think? How was the hike to get here?
It was pretty hard, but it was cool. It's really pretty.
Okay. Well, I'd like to see what's back there.
Okay.
Watch out for bats. Or the copper ore in the copper mine. Here we are on a day hike. Cypress Butte over there. Way back there you can see the Mazatzal Mountains. There's Tim and Tamara. Camps down there. Right. Down. There's our camp. Back up along the rock climbing site. And back here. Horseshoe Reservoir. Pause for a second. Back to it. Way back there, this is H.K. Mesa. Dove in that way. Phoenix is way down that way. This is all the Verde River. Looking west, northwest. Yeah, starting to look north. Way up there is the Muggy Own Rim. Above the Swarov and the Juniper and Kingdom Pine. And here comes our total 360 Cypress Butte. this is Mariah going over the rappel. This is a great time. Control the whole way. Oh, here we have Laura Lord. Laura, what are you doing?
I'm making dinner for our patrol.
All right, what are we having tonight?
Chicken stew. What? Yes, please.
Chicken stew, that sounds pretty good.
It actually smells pretty good compared to last night's dinner.
What did you have last night?
Calzones.
Dough balls.
Yep, sure thing. Didn't fry them long enough.
Oh, that's showing us. How do you set one of these rain flies up? What's that pole for?
The pole is to hold this part of it up. With this string here.
Ah, I see.
Okay. The backpack for tomorrow, because we're going to hike out of here really early.
Really early? Like, what's really early?
Well, they're saying 5 o'clock, but I think they're lying.
You know, I think you're right, because you know what? It's like at night, 5 o'clock?
It's cold and it's dark.
Totally dark.
No way.
Okay.
We're
thank you. Mr. Whitaker, what are you doing? What's that for?
Fire.
Fire, huh? Dan's middle name is Pyro.
Worse than Craig.
Worse than Craig? Okay, we're with Aaron Edmondson, and we just went up the hardest part of our climb. How you doing?
I made it. I feel a great sense of accomplishment, but it was very hard.
Great. How's your pack feeling?
It's not too bad. It's kind of hurting my hip, and it's feeling really heavy, but it's almost over.
Great. Well, how you feeling? Their camp's just right down the road, and you're about ready to set up. We're going to sit there for a day.
Well, hopefully there's a creek. I want to go swimming. I
smell. Okay, thanks.
Hi.
Hey, you just got through the biggest part of the climb that we got here. We just did about 2,500 feet in about a mile. How do you feel?
Oh, jeez, I'm really dying.
7 hours
so
of walking.
Sore.
9 feet? It's great. Look at Senno's arm. She just shredded it, man.
How your packs feel? Are they pretty heavy still?
Yeah.
But I can feel my muscles.
I think my boss is a part of my body now, so.
We're getting all buff here.
All right. Well, the camp's just down the road, so you guys can go rest up.
God loves us.
All right. Hi, Aaron.
Hi.
Dude, you got nasty in here.
No.
Oh, so sweet.
Ow. Okay.
God, I'm hating life, dude.
Chocolate coffee beef?
Big old cactus. Big old yucca shooting up a stalk. Way, way up there. A while back. Okay, now let's get this straight. How far did you hike today?
13.
I thought it was 5.
6, wasn't it?
What day is it?
Friday.
Monday.
Tuesday.
How many days have you been out?
10.
5.
We're on
4.
Four.
How many more days have you got?
2. 13.
6.
5.
6.
Great. Is your pack heavy?
No.
You ready to get to camp?
Yes, I need a potty.
Oh, okay. We'll get the. Hey, Matt.
What's up?
How's the hike?
Beautiful.
Piece of cake, right?
Oh, yeah.
Nothing to it.
Piece of cake. Gave him a head start. Almost caught him.
Let's see what Dan looks like.
Want to see his
like.
Pompadour? Great.
Come on, Dan. Let's see it.
Come on, Dan.
Oh, he's being uncooperative.
Okay.
But he's got a great pompadour, like the Johnny Suede.
He looks like a worm, you know.
A big green caterpillar.
Hey, no cameras in the morning.
Not loud, huh?
Oh, I'm out of here.
I know. Little journal writing.
It's crazy. Mountain cakes for breakfast.
Mountain cakes for breakfast?
Beyond your normal blueberry flapjacks.
I don't know. He's cooking up the leftover rice and roni from last night.
That goes in the pancakes also.
Anything left over, huh?
Everything left over.
Do they sink or do they float?
Definitely sink.
All right, sinkers.
Get you around these mountains. Clear the dead man and back. Or at least make a dead man. According to the map, if we take a compass bearing at 112 degrees to the east, we will be looking directly at Mazatzal Peak.
Over this way.
Yes.
You mean that one up there in the clouds?
The one with the snow.
Uh-huh.
Just the tree.
That basin over there is Dead Man Creek, then.
How do you get its name?
I don't know. Beats me.
Mazatzal Peak.
Yeah, over here you can see the Verde River way down there. Looks like a big thunderstorm today.
Further to the right.
Granite Basin.
Granite Basin.
Yeah. You're climbing for a good spot for a rock climbing site, except it'd be hard to get to. That's the way. We're coming back from a day hike today. One west of Mountain Springs, and when we came up Mountain Springs, we came up through this valley here, over that grassy ridge down in the Sycamore Creek, and we came down up further over this little divide here, and came on over to Mountain Springs, the trees down there. And then when we go out, we'll be going up back over this little mountain here, and on down. Way down in the distance, you can see Horseshoe Reservoir, way down there. And this is all Willow Creek, which flows into Horse Creek. And get back here a little bit. If we go way over this way, looks like we got some storms and Phoenix and Carefree, and all those places are way down kind of the southwest. Great place up here. Big ol' hawk flying around. Here's the patrol moving down towards Willow Springs. See him way up there. They're way up there. Go down to Willow Springs down here today, make our camp down in the cottonwoods. See Horse Creek going down. We have our solo way down there. You see, I think you can see the road. About 7 miles away, I guess. See a trail down below. There's Tim and Ken out in the front there. I'll be gonna stop and wave. there somewhere. I seem to find them. Sounds like they're in good spirits. I can hear them talking.
The wildflowers. These guys are really sharp. They got little sawtooth edges on there. Saws on the edges. Don't want to brush up against one of these guys.
So this is the view from Tim and Maya's bedroom here at Willow Springs and a sort of creek. Big old cottonwood all blooming out up there. Pretty nice place in the shade. Not too hot. That'll be a good night at old Willow Springs. We're looking here at Heidi's legs. Heidi, tell me about these legs.
Well,
how'd you get those scratches?
Some cactus and prickly pears and devil's claw and falling in the river and on rocks. And
you mean the usual way?
The usual way.
Oh, look. Now, let's see these legs. Are they all beat up?
They got a nasty bruise.
Not
here's
too
my
bad.
Climbing scar, Leach. Get that.
Oh, wait, climbing scar. Ooh.
Embedded in my
legs. All right, let's see Laura's
cactus.
Legs here.
Embedded in my leg, not
ow.
Just stuck, embedded.
Climbing scar. You know, one old guy around here always wears long pants.
Hey, I'm wearing long pants,
Mr. Yeah, we could look at his leg here.
Hey,
you know, there's absolutely no scratches on it at all.
I love the 1940s way of doing it. How can I wear it? I
two
sweat pair
of that hand.
And it's
I don't care anyone who sweats.
Well,
I just don't sweat.
Hey, two pairs of pants. Look at this stuff. And I still have cactus embedded in my leg.
That's crazy.
Oh, cool.
How are you not sweating to death?
I'm not hot.
Except for my face.
My face
is hot.
I'm
crying.
How does it feel, Santa?
It feels great, but I'm exhausted.
Alright. How are your legs?
They're not bad, actually. Tweezers? Really bumping.
Wow.
A little knock-knee, maybe.
Oh.
They're okay. Healing pretty quick. I'm kind of shy.
What's for lunch today?
Tuna crackers and cheese and peanut butter and honey.
Looks good. What are you making there, Aaron?
Tuna and crackers.
Uh-huh. I'm gonna feel this meter.
Hi.
Must be bath time. All the way, Eric. Talk to me next fall.
Next fall?
Yeah, January. psych this out
for
a little.
A little storm of 95, the one just like in 91 that I said would be over in a day. And 3 days later, it's still coming down.
With that storm, we didn't have any thunder.
Man, non-stop lightning and thunder. Beautiful sky, though.
What's it like in there? How was that storm?
Noisy.
Noisy. Rained again last night. Seems to be a really wet year down here this year. Got some nice paintbrush. Jobs here. This year have leaves on them. Maybe another week or so they have some little red blossoms on them. Comfortable with the desert?
Yeah.
Nothing out here that's gonna eat you.
No.
You ever taken a bath this whole time?
Yes, I took one last night.
And you brushed your teeth?
Yes, I did.
So you're feeling pretty good?
Feeling great.
Oh, cool. All right. See ya.
Bye.
It is. Must be Saturday, 25th. Everybody's on solo out here. And there's the mountains way back there. There's our solo camp. Down here on Horse Creek. Nice quiet day. Coming down Horse Creek. Down where the vans are. Panorama off to the north. Lots of saguaro out there. So here's kind of where the rock climbing site must be. top of that one. Maybe that one kind of in the dark there. There's also stuff there in the clouds. Creosote bushes. Lots of them too. Tall birds feeding up there on top of that sorrel. Turn up.
Whipping up the world famous fatty cakes of the desert.
Fatty cakes, huh?
Yep, topped with a little cream cheese and raspberry jelly. Just doesn't get any better than this.
So why do you come out here every year?
I think it's the scorpions. I have a deep relationship with scorpions. There's plenty of those out here.
Ever get stung?
Not yet, but I've stung a few of them. As Tim found out yesterday, he antagonized them a little. Let me show you how these fatty cakes are done. If I can find that cream cheese. I come back every year for the students, of course.
Sure.
More than one reason.
What are you hoping the students get out of this?
It's just neat to see the learning process that goes on. And it's the first experience for a lot of them to come out here. Be gone for this many days at a time. And we get to see a lot of neat terrain, and the sun sure is nice. It's snowing back at Denver.
So yeah.
Here we are, one more time.
Kind of lose track of time out here.
Sure do.
What day is it?
I would think it would be about Sunday, but couldn't guarantee that for sure.
Yeah. But it's warm.
Sleep and be merry.
Yeah. Okay, then over here, we have the young Mr. Pappy. But you, where are you out here? You've been out here four or five times in a row now.
Four or five times. It's exciting out here. It's relaxing. Come out and enjoy the sun, the students. Just being away from the city, all the people, the daily routine.
Better than working.
Definitely better than working, although I like my job. But it sure beats working. Lounging in the thermal loungers, eating good food. Getting to know the students. Good fun.
Yeah. What do you hope the students get out of this?
I hope they learn to push themselves beyond their normal, everyday challenges. I like to see them take the challenges they're faced with and push further than that, go beyond their limits. It's neat to see that. It's a good feeling for them and for myself to see. As a student, I did that quite a bit. Good feeling. Many challenges out of here.
I think what I was hoping is that this morning when I got up, that they'd be in their sleeping bags listening to the birds, listening to how quiet it was, and, you know, all alone out there on solo, just kind of listening to the world around them.
What were we doing?
That's what we were doing. I think you were sleeping, but...
I was thinking about these cakes. Hey, zoom in on this. Zoom in on this. Before I take a bite, got another one waiting for you, Mark.
A fatty cake, huh?
Gotta love
them. All right, let's see what his face does once he puts it in his mouth.
Lots of
cake. Well, on my way to pick up people off solo, found a big old matate, which is something that the Indians would use to grind their corn. You see where the grind marks are. They have the stone go back and forth to grind. sunflowers. Famous guy Tim Pappy. Give me a pearl of wisdom here. How you doing? Are you limping?
Yeah.
Why are you limping?
I messed up my knee.
Oh, bummer.
How are you, Mark?
I'm fine. How are you, Beth?
Oh, hanging in there.
Great. Almost there.
Yep.
Hard.
Thank you.
How'd it go, Ryan?
Oh, it went great, Mark. Wonderful trip again.
Yeah.
Great group of students.
Whipped them into shape.
Hopefully they'll be back here next year.
Yeah.
They're a little worn, but they're loving life. They got a real good attitude right now.
All right. He's been in the desert for 9 days now. I'm blocking the path to get to the van. What are you going to do about that? How was it? It was hard, huh?
Yeah, I thought it was.
Everybody says this course is too easy. Yeah, I know.
I'm the only honest one.
Yeah, well, we're out of here.
Yeah.
What's up, Dan? How was your bath?
Huh?
How was your bath?
It was good.
All right.
It was refreshing.
People who dropped their camera in the river.
Yeah.
For the patrol that was there.
Some people like,
keep your negatives too, because I'm gonna go.
Some just like tuna.
The tuna was good, we just need a few
guys. Tuna and crackers, that's good. 1/14th day of the trip.
And one. Jeez, Heidi, I can't believe we got
that. Hey, I just want to thank my patrol, because I think we all got along. We didn't even start really getting on each other's nerves until right before the solo, and that came at a good time anyway. So like, yes! I want to be by myself! I also want to thank my patrol for putting up with me because I happen to be kind of slow. And she doesn't wear sunscreen.
I don't wear sunscreen.
No.
Watching you get up, actually.
I'm going free across in. Colorado return from field studies type trip. Everybody's feeling good.